Thank you. High School. And on behalf of the Aztec Municipal School District, I would like to welcome you to Fred Cook Stadium for the Aztec High School Class of 2023 Commencement Ceremony. Let's give a quick round of applause to... Let's give another quick round of applause to our band for walking in our graduates this evening. This time, I would ask that you please rise and remove your hats for the presentation of the colors by the Aztec High School's JRTC Color Guard team under the direction of Lieutenant Colonel Randy Villardi and Sergeant First Class Victor Snover. Posting the colors on stage will be Cadet Second Lieutenant Clint Hunt, Cadet Command Sergeant Major Dalton Harrington, Cadet First Lieutenant Sierra Cornish, and Cadet Sergeant Isaiah Van Meter. Our national anthem will be sung by the Aztec Choir. Please remain standing until the color guard has left the field. Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem. Thank you. Please take your seats. Aztec Municipal School District rests on the ancestral lands of the Apache Nations, the Diné Navajo Nation, Pueblos, and Ute tribes since the time immemorial. It is important to acknowledge the ancestral caretakers of the land we reside on as we learn, work, and build relationships with the indigenous peoples of this land. We respectfully acknowledge that no words are enough. Joining us on stage tonight from the Diné Navajo Nation is Madam Vice President Rochelle Montoya. Can we please give her a quick round of applause for taking time out of her busy schedule to join us to support our students? I also need to say thank you to our wonderful maintenance and custodial crews. They did a great job today getting this facility ready. We were here right at the last minute dumping chairs and wiping things down, trying to make sure that our beautiful ceremony could take place. Thank you guys so much for our Aztec High School Council. Our Aztec High School Student Council, under the guidance of Ms. Anna Strauss, did an amazing job with the planning for tonight's event. Thank you, Ms. Strauss and her team. I also need to say thank you to Ms. Roberta Randall for all her efforts in preparing programs and transcripts and so much more. Will you finally join me in recognizing our amazing teachers, counselors, and staff that have all gone above and beyond for these wonderful students? Please give everyone a round of applause.
Gentlemen, will you please remove your head coverings and will you bow your heads and join me in prayer? Dear Heavenly Father, I want to start by thanking you for all that you have done. Thank you for guiding us through our academic journey. I ask for continued guidance as we move on to the next chapter of our lives. Please bless us with the strength and wisdom to face any challenges that come our way. Help us to use our talents and knowledge for the greater good. I thank you for everyone who has helped us and guided us so we could be here today. Our families, friends, teachers, coaches, administrators, and everyone else that has been there. I pray that you give us all peace as we step into new beginnings. Help us with each challenge we may encounter. Give us the wisdom to solve it and allow us to overcome any conflict that comes our way. I ask all these blessings, and it's in your name I pray. Amen.
Thank you for unselfishly sharing your time, talent, and knowledge with us. Yes, we know it was your job to do it, but many of you went beyond the line to help us, taking the time to explain the assignments and play the games, sometimes even repeatedly because we wouldn't pay attention, allowing us to come to you for extra help before or after school to ensure that we understood on your own free time, giving us the extra encouragement that we can and will do it. You all demand excellence from us, setting the bar high in order for us to live it up. Tonight, we are here to show you that we did it, all because you didn't give up on us.
To our parents, thank you for supporting us in more ways possible. Dragging us out of bed every morning, making sure we were fed and clothed for school every day. Herding us out the door, whether to be off the bus on time for school or to be ready in the car for you to take us. The late nights to help us with homework as you cried while many of you were exhausted yourselves. All while listening to the elementary drama about how we didn't get a juice box that day. Coming to our music concerts, sporting events, and even chaperoning our school dances. These are just a few of many of ways you as our parents supported us along this journey.
So on behalf of the graduates, we would like to say thank you. Thank you for all that you have done and continue to do. We sit here as a result of your love and your dedication. Thank you for joining us this evening, and welcome to the 2023 Aztec High School graduation ceremony.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I would like to introduce our platform dignitaries. Please hold your applause until all dignitaries have been introduced. The Aztec Board of Education, Ms. Fran Doby, President. Mr. Jimmy Duzeberry, Vice President. Ms. Lacey Phillips Newland, Secretary. Mr. Paul Bandy, Member. Mr. Paul Markin, Member. Aztec School District Administration, Mr. Kevin Summers, Superintendent. Ms. Lauren Laws, Associate Superintendent of Teaching and Learning. Navajo Nation, Rochelle Montoya, Vice President. And the Aztec High School Administration, Mr. Brandon Thurston, Principal. Ms. Sharda Sanders, Assistant Principal. Mr. Robbie Hess, Assistant Principal. And Mr. Corey Grock, Athletic Director. Thank you.
Graduates, staff members, and honorable guests, it is our honor to stand before you today to celebrate the achievements of these remarkable graduates. On behalf of the Aztec High School Class of 2023, we would like to extend our sincerest congratulations and appreciation to each and every one of you sitting here with us today.
Graduation is one of the biggest, most memorable milestones of our lives, and it marks the accumulation of 4 years of hard work, dedication, and sacrifice. Today we all gather to recognize and celebrate the achievements of all of these graduates who have demonstrated outstanding academic excellence, leadership, and community service.
To our fellow graduates, we want to express our heartfelt admiration and gratitude for your hard work, perseverance, and resilience. Your dedication to your education and personal growth has not gone unnoticed. We have all inspired each other with displays of our passion and creativity and hard work.
We would also like to recognize our faculty members, staff, and coaches who have helped us come this far. They showed us around and introduced us to this new world we've been in for the next 4 years. Some stood by our sides, guiding us along the way, and others had to drag us down the road. Although we may not show up, but we are very grateful for you all.
As we move further along this road, remember all the life lessons, the good times, the bad times, everything between and beyond that we have learned here. Growing up around everyone sitting here with us.
Watching them evolve to the people they are today and will continue to grow. Our friends we've gone to school with since pre-K to our friends that have recently joined us. Our memories we've created together and our achievements we all have celebrated together.
So as we all accomplish this milestone together, once again we'd like to congratulate this graduating class of 2023 and a big thank you to all of you here supporting us. From our family outside of school to our family inside of school, thank you for always pushing us and helping us accomplish these last 4 years. And we wish all the best for our fellow students, our beloved guests, and our amazing staff here at Aztec High School.
At this time, we'll have the song, Remember You Young, by Thomas Rhett.
Hey, buddies, that I grew up with, Australia's to marry love now. You ain't fooling me, was long ago. We tore the roof off that one red light town. And hey, darling, sipping that red wine. All classic kid back on the couch. You smile and see it, shooting tequila, a shutting down college bars down.
Are we good? When we lose someone we love, we must learn not to live without them, but to live with the love that they left behind.
Today, the class of 2023 is graduating, and unfortunately, one of our fellow classmates is not with us. Let us take a moment in silence to remember Amanda Henry.
Sharing good times with good friends is the greatest joy. These are the things that make life worthwhile. We must all be grateful for the relationships that come our way. We must never take for granted the gift of friendship that is bestowed upon each and every one of us.
Amanda was not only a student. She was a friend, mentor, and a shoulder to lean on. She was all about being positive, and she always had a smile on her face.
This bright soul and kind heart touched us personally. New Mexico is known for our beautiful sunsets, and we know that Amanda has been painting the skies ever since.
In honor of Amanda, we have set up a chair and have placed a flower on it.
At this time, our AHS choir will be singing Homeward Bound by Marta Keene in honor of Amanda.
Knows I don't like to label students as smart or otherwise. I like to teach everyone to do their very best work so they can succeed. but objectively, Madeline Lischke is smart. She learns easily and well, and she knows that this is a talent she did not earn. It is not her biggest accomplishment. What she has practiced and worked at and achieved is bravery. She is one of the bravest people I know. She has such deep anxiety that just a few years ago, she wasn't able to attend pep rallies. Sometimes she had to leave class just to get away from all the people. And she is still challenged by crowds, but she has overcome that as well. Her bravery has not just grown so that she can do things like speak to you here today, but I also see it in how she treats others. She has spent hundreds of hours volunteering with Key Club and working as a volunteer at San Juan Regional Hospital. She plans to be a physician. She's kind, like a maniac. She makes the world a better place with no thought to herself, no consideration of cost or reward. And helping others is an act of bravery, because it does have a cost. It takes time and effort that you could have kept for yourself. Sometimes people don't want help, even when they need it. It can make them feel sad and angry. They may even refuse your help. Earlier this year, while Madeline was getting those grades, volunteering, and working a job, one of her friends had a serious housing issue, and she had to go live with relatives in Farmington. She didn't have transportation to get to our school anymore. Madeline was brave enough to help even when her friend wanted to give up. Madeline drove every morning to Farmington, extra early just in case she had to wake up her friend and wait for a few minutes. And they were both mad at each other a lot of the time during that time. But today they are both graduating, and I am so proud of both of you. But Madeline, she is a role model for me. The way that she fights for her friends and with her friends is something that I want to be. And I am so glad to have had her as a student and a friend these 4 years. She has made me a better person, a braver person. I am happy to introduce your salutatorian for the class of 2023, Madeline Lischke.
Seniors, family, and friends, as well as faculty and administration. First off, I want to give a huge thank you for Ms. Lay for her kind words and for introducing me tonight. My name is Madeline Lischke, and I am the salutatorian for the 2023 Aztec graduating class. Being up here is definitely an honor, but a little out of my comfort zone. When I first started high school, I would have never imagined being on this stage speaking in front of you all. I think the very thought of it might have made me cry. But here we are. When I was a freshman in high school, as Ms. Alay said, I could barely make it through a week of school without panicking in the counselor's office and being sent home. I would cry and shake over any little problem. Despite those struggles, I am up here in front of you speaking. I am going to UNM for the fall semester for a major in biochemistry in order to go to medical school to become a pediatric psychiatrist, in order to help kids who went through the same struggles as me. I really do appreciate this school for helping me overcome my own self-doubt. Some of us have been together all the way since kindergarten. We have seen the best of each other and the worst of each other. But today, we all came to walk together on this stage and to get our diplomas after 12 long years. After this, we will all part ways and move in many different directions in life. Whether some of us go to college, or if we enter the workforce right away. But whatever path you have decided to go on, you have done an amazing job, and I truly mean that. I remember at the beginning of the year when our principal, Mr. Thurston, said that these shouldn't be the best years of our lives. And I agree with that. These 4 years have helped us starting to define who we are as people, and I hope you will use that, what you have learned in high school, to become the best version of yourself. You never know what kind of impact you are going to have on someone and what is going on in their lives. Be kind and never let anyone tell you who you are supposed to be. I have been so fortunate to have people in my life that have supported me every step of the way, like my parents, my family, my friends, real friends, and teachers. I've had some struggles of my own, and each of these people have helped me through them. I would like to thank three special teachers in high school that have impacted me the most. Ms. Hartman, Ms. Lay, and Ms. Lucero. They have been amazing teachers and role models for me. They have been there, always lending me a helping hand or an ear whenever I needed it, and I will forever be grateful for their guidance and compassion throughout the years. I want you all to have the best life, and congratulations to all of you who are here today. Goodbye.
It is an honor to introduce you to an educator who has spent the last 16 years working with students, parents, teachers, and our communities. We would like to thank you for your dedication, commitment, and service to making our schools inspired, safe, and fulfilled. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome to microphone the Superintendent of Schools for Aztec, Mr. Kevin Summers.
Good evening. Ladies and gentlemen, it brings me great pleasure tonight to be able to introduce to you the 17 honor graduates for the class of 2023. I would ask that you please hold your applause until all of them have been introduced. Honor graduates, please remain standing until all of the other honor graduates have been announced. Ariana Acree, Miles Bodie, Melissa Chandler, Madison Edwards, Catherine Grady, Annalie Jacobo, Ava Jarvis, Mackenzie Klinger, Caden Lee, Madeline Litschke, Brianna Martin, Michaela Munoz, Tamantha Proft, Samira Valenzuela, Eric Vilchis Hernandez, Ethan Villanueva, and John Villarreal Owens.
God opened up to stop the shower for this graduation for you guys. Hi, most of you know me. I'm Coach Herb Stinson. This is my fifth and most likely my last graduation to have the God-given privilege to speak at. Coincidentally, the last Aztec graduate I had the privilege to introduce was Bella Wells. Some of you remember her? She happened to just graduate last week with honors from New Mexico Tech. And it's an honor to introduce this young man, this year's valedictorian, John Villarreal Owens. Or more commonly known as John V, because I couldn't say his name forever. While deciding just how to introduce him, I came across several accurate words, but this one fit the best. Extraordinary. It's defined as going beyond what is usual. Other alternatives are uncommon, unusual, remarkable. But the one I like for him the best is exceptional. John V is a most exceptional young man. His work ethics, athletically, academically, religiously, and socially, is legendary. How do I know this? Because I've had the front row seat the past 4 years to witness it myself. I know that while John V. volunteers his time to serve a mission for the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints and then attend a college of his choice and beyond, great things will happen because he is an extraordinary, and extraordinary people make great things happen, no matter what the circumstances. Please join me in welcoming and congratulating this year's 2023 Aztec High School valedictorian, John V.
Good evening, faculty, staff, parents, and fellow students. I'm honored to be standing here today as your valedictorian. I'd like to thank Coach Stinson. Great coach, great man. I truly appreciate you. I'm going to be a little bit unusual today. I'm, like he said, extraordinary, I guess, right? I'd like to start by addressing the parents. It all starts in the home. If you want a child to be successful, then do things to make sure that. Show and teach them to love and care. Hold high expectations and standards for them. Teach them to work hard and believe in themselves. Don't ever believe there's something your child cannot accomplish. Your fears are not theirs. Your limits are not theirs. Don't be scared to punish them when they fall short, and they will fall short. I fall short constantly. So. Your child will turn out however you shape them. I've experienced this in my own life, right? My mom taught me that if I kept straight A's, I was able to play sports. And I loved playing sports throughout middle school and high school. That was my passion for a long time. So the only reason I'm standing here today as class 2023 valedictorian is because my mom pushed me. And I thank her for that. Believe in yourself and believe in your children. Now, I know I'm not a parent. And I know I've never experienced being a parent, but hopefully someday, right? I say these things because it's proven to be true. Your child's success starts in your home. I would also like to address my class, my fellow students, my friends, my peers. I know that we've all faced challenges in our time here at Aztec High School. We've had to deal with the loss of loved ones, the stress of academic pressure, and the ever-present challenges of growing up. But through it all, we've persevered, right? We're here, let's go. We've learned, we've grown, and we've become stronger, and now we're ready to move on to the next chapter of our lives. As we go our separate ways, I want to leave you with a few words of advice. First, always live from your best judgment. Your gut feeling is probably correct. All right. Second, wisdom is not knowledge. All right. It's what we've learned from living amongst each other. When you can make peace within yourself and all aspects of your life, you have gained wisdom. And I encourage you to share that wisdom. Third, try new things. Listen to others, because nobody sees things exactly the same way. Two heads are better than one, right? Experience new things. Learn something new. Keep learning. Never settle. Never be content with the knowledge that you've attained at any given point through your life. Continuously learning will keep your mind engaged and strengthen your overall focus. Strive to perfect each skill you know, and you'll never be bored. All right. At the end of the day, if you've done everything, seen everything, experienced everything, then you've lived. But we haven't lived until we die. So keep expanding your circle of life, knowledge, experience, and wisdom. Some of us figured this out sooner than later, and some of us might have not truly figured it out. I've heard many times to find yourself and know who you are, and I'd like to emphasize this. Learn your likes and dislikes. More importantly, learn your values and learn to use those values. Try to absorb what people teach you and preach, but understand what you should believe and shouldn't. If you can learn to do this, then you'll be able to form an informed opinion on anything. It's okay to have strong opinions about different things and topics, and it's okay to argue and disagree with people. Just keep it light. I need you all to know that you have great potential. Understand this potential, guys. Find yourself, your identity, know who you are, be confident, all right, guys? Don't ever underestimate yourself and what you can do, because you can do great things. However, finally, I would just like to thank the faculty and staff who've made Aztec High School a great place to learn. Since I've been in high school, the campus has improved a lot. You know, we've gotten fences, more security. We've got these big old orange doors, right? We got these new high-tech cameras that, like, move around. Miss Sanders is over there on the thing. No, I'm just kidding. But I'm grateful for all the opportunities that you've given me for the education that I've received here. Thank you, guys. I'd also like to thank my parents and family for their love and support. I could not have done this without you. And finally, I'd like to thank my friends, all right? They've been with me through high school, through the thick and thin, right? You've made my life unforgettable so far, right? It's been great these past 4 years. You know, high school may have seemed like such a large part of our lives, and it may feel scary now that it's over, but we're barely starting, guys. As we go our separate ways, I know we'll all do great things. I'm confident that we'll make the world a better place. Class of 2023, I thank you. Good luck. Goodbye.
Great job. So right now, on behalf of the faculty and staff of Aztec High School, it has been my privilege to work with these incredible students, guests, family members, members of the Aztec Municipal School Board, and Mr. Summers. I would like to highlight a few of the accomplishments from this year's graduating class. We have 140 graduates before you today. 99% of them have been accepted to a 2 or 4 year college. They've generated over $1.6 million in scholarships and grant awards. We have a Daniels Fund Scholarship Award winner with Miss Madison Edwards. That entitles her to a full ride scholarship any place in the country. We have over 300 dual enrollment successfully completed courses with 918 college credits earned. 4 of our seniors have 20 college credits to their name, and 2 have chose to serve our nation in the armed forces. Students, you've done some great many things in high school. I truly hope you look back at fond memories of your time there, that you've made some great friends and some lasting memories. I cannot wait to see where you guys go. Superintendent Summers, members of the board, I am here to certify that the following graduates have fulfilled the requirements of the State of New Mexico and Aztec Municipal School Board of Education, and they have all earned their high school diplomas. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Eric Vilches Hernandez. Michaela Marie Munoz. Kaden Ray Lee. John Richard Villarreal Owens. Ethan Neil Villanueva. Miles Dalton Bodie. Ava Bell McCray Jarvis. Annalie Guadalupe Jacobo. Samantha Croft. Melissa Chandler. Brianna Nicole Martin. Madeline Grace Litschke. Ariana Lauren Acree. Madison Ray Edwards. Samira Brooke Valenzuela. Mackenzie Dakota Klingler. Catherine Victoria Grady. Brennan Mark Shoval. Itzel Hernandez. Isaiah Christopher Daddy Lovato. Catherine Amelia Campos. Isabella Faith Montoya. Cambry Jewel Laster. Juliana Bixler. Camry Rayanne Johnson. Serenity Jerkins. Shelby Ray George. Nikaylin and Nakai. Aaliyah Lee Moss. Barber. Jedediah Jones. Anna. Cecilia Virata.
Vigil.
Edward Daniel Grotto Jr. Tristan McNeil. Rebecca Jean Voss. Amika Brianna Wilson. Raimundo Hokoma Dimas. Isabella Francis Acuna. Deshauna Angel Charlie. Kalila Mae Lewis. Miriam Soraya Medina. Greyaz. John Cody Hargis. Dwayne Shelby. Jamie Tate Telfer. Dakota Simkovitz. Chance Michael Howlett. Josefina Estrella Silva. Evan Thomas Concepcion. Reason Harmony Lynn Ellis. Emily Alexis Vindiola. Nicole Emily Espinoza. Aiden Shaw Pittman. Lauren Cameron Wasson. Victor Boucher. Raquel Geneva James. Molly Autumnwood Sines. Rosalinda Vargas. Liliana Salas Villapando. Kristen Rose Mary Hughes. Mabry Marshall Holbert. Rose Maloof. Mira Kayomi Jones. Damon Ethan Williper. Dwight Nathan Castleberry. Isaiah Sanchez. Jacob Prada Johnson. Madison Denise Creeby. Isaiah Slam Zelinsky. Jason B. Hawkins. Adam Montoya III. Allison Marie Cates. Brody Merle Benally.
Sergio A. Flores. Garrett John McClure. Nathan Harris. Emilio Jaheim Hilliard. Alondra Calderon. Tyrell Lee Coho. Evan Allen. And Elijah James Lee Greenwood.
And free enough to drive on our own with the windows down on warm summer nights.
We grew up anxiously waiting for the bell to ring at the beginning and end of each day. We grew up reading picture books and then moved on to chapter books. Now, here we are closing one chapter of our lives and turning the page to a new one.
We grew up learning and earning wisdom from the teachers we've had over the past 13 years, who have ignited something within us to be our best selves.
We grew up with the world at our fingertips, the internet shaping and shifting everything around us. We've seen abundant transformations through fashion and social media, not realizing we were transforming too.
What we didn't see was how fast we were growing up, and somehow the past 13 years flew by. Years waiting for this very moment turned into months. Months turned into days. Days turned into weeks. Months turned into weeks. Weeks turned into days. And days that have now come to an end. But the growth we did was beautiful.
We grew up dreaming about the day we get to go off on our next adventure. Joking about how we couldn't wait until graduation. Eager to explore the world. And here I stand before you today as we take our first steps down divergent paths.
We grew up overcoming unforeseen difficulties. We overcame the many challenges we faced throughout our high school years, from experiencing the unknowns of COVID, unspoken hardships, and even losing loved ones. I know everyone here has had their struggles, but we still made it to this day.
We grew up making cherished memories that will last a lifetime. Laughing and staying up until the sun rose with our friends, countless nights cheering in the student section, or even playing out on the field.
And even though we grew up full of dreams and disappointments, difficulties and successes, tears and laughter, we know we still have growing to do. And we are grateful for the moments that have brought us to here.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, class of 2023, we grew up.
Good evening, fellow neighbors, parents, esteemed members of the board, and graduating class of 2023. Congratulations. I had a whole speech prepared, but I'll speak from the heart because that's what I do best. Congratulations for accomplishing an important milestone. Perseverance through adversity and taking yet another step forward into the forever. Excuse me, our forever. I ask now that you take a look around you. Absorb the environment that you're in. Take a look at the person on your right and take a look at the person on your left. And put each other inside of your hearts forever. Because, ladies and gentlemen, our forever is about to start in just a few moments. And now, I ask only that you pray with me, that we pray to our Lord, our King of Kings. We pray that He may place His Heavenly Father, His Heavenly Spirit with us today, in a mighty way that we may never forget our accomplishments, our adversity, our triumphs, our hardships, to spread the glory of ourselves into our future endeavors, to ask that we hold each other in the darkest of times, because believe me, there will be dark times ahead of us, but never forget how strong you are. And I ask each and every one of you to promise me that you will conquer the darkness and illuminate it with our light and our glory. Please bow our heads as I pray to our Heavenly Father. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
And now please move your
castle from the right to left,